record this for a minute. All right, because Sister Stephanie is not gonna be with us today, because she has been invited to a meeting with some church in the United States, you know, something like that. So she's not gonna be with us today. Let me share my screen for a minute.
Brother Danilo, I'm sorry.
Go ahead.
In this moment, I am not at home. The reason I'm gonna listen the all the class. I'm gonna be in the class. I'm gonna listen all, and I'm going to participate if I can. Okay.
Uh huh. Okay.
Okay. Thank you much.
All right. Okay, let me open here this one right here. Okay, let me minimize this. Okay. You see in my screen, right?
Yes, brother.
Okay. Okay, we're seeing two things over here. Either and neither, right? There's ways to use either and neither. And the first way is to use it. It's like a replace when we want to use either for a positive sentence. We can change to for either. So it says over here that we use to and either at the end of the sentence, like you have over here. We use to after a positive verb right here, right? Says I am happy. I am happy too. We use two over here, right? You see that? But we use the negative verb. This negative verb is supposed to be on this side. So we use either after a negative verb right here. I am not happy. I'm not happy either. You see that we change that two over here for either, because here in two is también in Spanish, but here in the negative sentence means tampoco. Okay, so that's two ways. If I say I am happy in a positive way, then I am happy too. But if I'm gonna say a negative way, I'm gonna say I'm not happy either. I cannot say I'm not happy too. That's wrong to say that way. We have to say I'm not happy either. Over here, say I enjoyed the film. I enjoy it too. And in this side, the negative way, you see that this verb is negative, and this verb over here, not happy, is negative. Entonces, if I use this negative verb over here, I'm gonna add either. I cannot either. I can't could, and I can't either. See? It's not hard to use this. There's another ways to use it, but this is the most common ways to use this either. Over here, we have some examples to this. It says either is used when referring to a choice between two options. If you got two options to pick up from one to the other one, so you're gonna use either. Either one deserves to win. Over here, if you have, two friends, right, that are competing in a sport, I don't know, you know, any sport, then you can say to your friend, either one deserves to win. Cualquiera de los dos puede ganar. This deserves. How you say deserves in Spanish?
Merecer.
Merecer, thank you. Okay, very good. And the other one here says either you leave or I will phone the police. You see that you have those two options. Either you leave or I will phone the police. See that? So there's two options over here. And look another thing that is at the beginning of the sentence. It's not at the end, like over here. Why is at the beginning? Because we use either when the verb is negative. Okay? In this case, this is not a negative sentence. Either you leave or I will phone the police. Okay, that's the way we use either. It can also be used in a negative way. Watch this. instead of the words also, or to, or so, if you're familiar with this word, you can mostly use either instead, and the meaning will remain the same. That means if you can use these words, this one right here, and you can change it for this one, and the meaning is gonna be the same. It's not gonna change. I haven't visited there either. See that? I haven't visited there either. This is a good restaurant. It's not expensive either. Okay. See, that goes at the end. Why it goes at the end? Because the verb is a negative state. Would you like to eat now or later? Either is fine. This is the two choices. See that? You have two choices over here. Would you like to eat now or later? The two options that you have over here. The answer is either is fine. You can either yolk or run. See, you can either yolk or run. See, so you can use either in this way. When it's a positive verb, you use to, or you use also, or you use so. Brother Harry, say another word. What was the word you were using? Else? Brother Harry, when we start talking?
As well.
Exactly, as well. Mm-hmm. Okay, so you use it in a positive way. You're gonna use to, you're gonna use so, you're gonna use also, etc. But in a negative way, in the negative, when the verb is a negative, it's negative, so you're gonna use either over here. Remember that this either is a positive sentence. There is not a definition in the dictionary for either, because either change in the meaning wherever either is put in the sentence. Here, over here says tampoco, right? Yo no puedo tampoco, yo no soy capaz. So that depends on the sentence that we use, then we give the meaning to the either. If you translate this word over here into Spanish, this sentence into Spanish, how do you say that in Spanish? How do you translate either you leave or I will phone the police? Can anyone translate that into Spanish?
O se va o llamo a la policía.
You see that you give them a different meaning? See the meaning, yes, over here? Was tampoco, right?
No.
And see the difference over here? O te, yes, vas, o yo llamaría a la policía. And there is other meanings for this word, depends on who, the way you understand this sentence, okay? And over here is the same thing. This is a good restaurant. It's not expensive either. Tampoco es caro. Would you like to eat now or later? Either is fine. How you translate this one right here?
Como te gustaría comer ahora o después? Como igual es bien, pues no sé. Como
yo diría, no, como cualquiera de las dos está bien.
Eso.
En inglés sabemos que es either, right? Y esa palabra, pues el americano lo va a entender fácilmente. Pero cuando nosotros la traducimos al español, le damos un diferente significado, dependiendo en dónde está la palabra y dependiendo de esa frase. So, would you like to eat now or later? ¿Te gustaría comer ahora o más tarde? Cualquiera de las dos está bien. Podría yo decir así. Brother Harry, do you have another translation for this? Either is fine.
Nah, that is good.
Right? Like this one over here. Look, this one over here. This one over here, I don't see no meaning for that either. Do you have any meaning for that either? You can either yolk or run. How do you translate that in Spanish?
Brother, what is the meaning of job?
No correr, sino un paso suave. ¿Cómo es?
Marchar.
Sí, como marchar, eso, ir suave, suave, porque correr es rápido, pero ir lentamente, marchar, sí, sí, como marchar, ir lento.
O trotar.
Trotar, exacto, okay. Eso, trotar. So, ¿cómo, ahí cómo se traduciría esa palabra?
No, no tiene como traducción, tú puedes trotar o correr.
Exacto, para nosotros, ¿cierto? Porque yo puedo decir, you can, yo puedo quitar este either over here, ¿cierto? Y dejar así, you can jog or run. Tú puedes correr, tú puedes trotar o correr. Pero ¿por qué le ponen el líder? ¿Por qué creen ustedes que le pusieron ese líder? ¿Por qué el americano le puso el líder? Eso lo dijimos anteriormente.
Para notar que hay dos opciones.
Exactamente. Porque la palabra, porque la frase representan que dos opciones. Y para poder diferenciar entre las dos opciones debemos usar el either. Es como cuando está la hermanita en a church, right? Y está hablando y después está cantando. Entonces, ¿usted qué le dice? Or either you sing or you talk. ¿Sí? ¿Ves? Entonces, le das esa opción. O hablas o cantas. Pero en inglés tenemos que usar ese either. Either you talk or sing. And this. Oh, look at this one. This dress doesn't fit me either. See, it says over here. This dress doesn't fit me either. Este vestido no me cabe tampoco. ¿Por qué ese either al final? Why that either at the end? Because the verb fit is in negative. What happened here? Okay. I don't know why I say choose. Okay, that's either. Now look at the neither. Now, says over here that neither has a negative connotation. Okay, it means not either. It's the opposite of either. But just remember that neither is often defined as none of. The dictionary definition is not one and not the other of two things. O sea, ninguno de los dos. Eso es lo que quiere decir ahí. No es ninguno de los dos. Ni es este ni es el otro. Entonces mira lo que dice. Neither one of the children were well behaved. Neither one. ¿Qué quiere decir esto? Que ninguno de los dos niños se portaron bien. Neither one of the children were well behaved. That's why over here says the dictionary definition is not one and not the other of two things. You understand that part? Any questions on that part right there? Now over here, which one do you would like to do? Neither. Both are terrible. See? O sea, it's not an option. It's not an option. Like the either. It's not even. It's not one, not the other one. Or it's not one, neither the other one. I can say that. So which one would you like to do? Neither. Both are terrible. Ninguno de los dos. Olvídese, ninguno de los dos. Over here said, we have two dogs. Neither one can sit. Ninguno de los dos. See that? Jenny didn't go to the park. Neither did Jane. Ni Jenny fue, ni Jane tampoco. Neither Ben nor Max will talk to the other. I can say, neither George or Viviana, neither George or Viviana want to go to the party. Neither, ninguno de los dos quiere ir al party. So I use the neither at the beginning of the sentence when I talk about two things that have the same two persons that have the same. Ah man, I forgot that word. Huh? What do you say, Sister Karen?
Teacher, excuse me. I have a question with this. Which one you would like to do? Or which one do you like to do?
Which one do you like to do? Which one?
Do, yes, okay. Entonces ahí va do. Which one do you like to do?
Yes.
Okay.
Which one? Do you like to do? And that will be a question, no?
Yes.
Because you're using the WH question, which? Which one? Do you like?
Yes.
Do you like to do?
Sino que estaba escribiendo esta y sí me parecía rara porque le falta el do al segundo ejemplo.
Which one you like to do?
Teacher, excuse me. Ahí hay un modal, el would modal, entonces no se puede poner el do sino el would.
Why, exactly.
antes del you.
Which
es
one
que
would?
Eso. Sino que es que va, o would you like o do you like. En el segundo ejemplo. También, esa es la pregunta, ¿Se puede poner antes el pronombre, antes del modal?
Like this?
Ajá. Esa, así es como yo la conozco, pero en el ejemplo está antes el pronombre. Mi pregunta es, ¿se puede usar de las dos maneras?
El pronombre, ¿cuál yo mira el pronombre?
No, you. No. Acá en el segundo ejemplo que usted tiene.
Aquí, which one you would like to do, you.
Espérame un momentico, me disculpa, lo voy a rayar aquí. Este ejemplo. Vale.
Es que hay.
Mi pregunta. O sea, ¿hay un error o se puede usar así también? El pronombre primero antes
which
del modal.
Which one you would like to do. No, se pueden las dos.
Ah,
es
okay.
Es el énfasis que se hace en la oración. Aquí hay un énfasis.
Ok, ok.
¿Dónde está what I mean? Aquí hay un énfasis. Okay. Which one you would like to do. Aquí está el énfasis en la oración, aquí en esta parte. En esta que está aquí no hay un énfasis. Which one would you like to do? Because it's a modal verb. Este es un modal verb. Que es el pasado de will, right?
Mm-hmm.
Teacher.
Go ahead.
Bueno, nosotros nos enseñaron siempre en el colegio y que uno siempre pone el, ¿cierto? En el caso del modal, lo pone primero, luego el pronombre, luego el verbo, ¿cierto? Para formar las oraciones. Pero cuando estaba estudiando allí en la Luis Amigo, me enseñaron que así usted ponga primero el pronombre o el verbo, ya sea would o sea do, que, o sea, lo correcto es poner el primero pronombre en este caso, perdón, el pronombre no, el auxiliar, would.
El wood,
se pone primero el you, según como uno haga la frase, o sea, si uno le pone el acento, así como en español. Uno dice, quiero comer carne. O, cierto, quiero comer carne, que en inglés también se puede. Así usted lo ponga al revés, que
sí, por según eso,
como
eso.
Uno lo pronuncie, se entiende que es una pregunta.
Eso. Eso es lo que le dije a ella. Es el énfasis que se le pone en la oración. ¿Entiendes? Como usted está diciendo. Entonces, ahí depende de dónde usted coloque el pronoun para el énfasis que usted va a hacer. Pero de las dos formas, este yo acá o este yo aquí, aquí está bien. Cualquiera de las dos formas lo puede hacer. Lo que pasa es que una tiene como más peso que la otra en cuanto a lo que usted quiere decir. Así como usted me dijo, ¿me entiende? Así como usted dice. Entonces, sí, cualquiera de las dos está bien. Ah, que es que como el inglés es tan extenso y tan vasto.
Listo, teach. Sí, sino que uno a veces conoce solo lo básico.
Sí. Sí, pero eso es, eso está bien. Eso está bien. Ok, este either and neither. Este que está aquí, neither do I, es para preguntas, ¿no? Para preguntas negando, ¿no? Este neither do I, neither, yo tampoco lo hago. All right, that's one thing. Let's go to the other one, to the other thing that I got over here. Let me close this and open. I think it's this one. Let me see this one. No. This one right here. Okay, there is a test over here. Let's do this test, see if we understood a little bit the either or neither, okay? So you guys gonna tell me what I gonna use over here. Choose the correct form to use both, either or neither to complete the sentence, all right? So the first one, can what? Can neither you or Lisa take me to the station? Or can both you and Lisa take me to the station? Or can either you or Lisa take me to the station? Which one do you use in this sentence?
Both. No. Can you both?
Both? Okay. What about number two? They're all the same. Either, neither, or both.
Neither. Neither.
Okay. Who's here today? Who's here? Vivi, are you there?
Yes, I'm here. Oh, okay. I'm learning.
But you can participate too in this question. Help Karen too and Brother Harry, Brother George too. See, because if you think Sister Karen is not right in the answer, so you can say, no, I think it's the other one. So we take votes. Okay, are you from Spain or from Italy?
No estoy en la explicación de voz.
¿Ah?
No estoy en la explicación de voz.
¿Both? ¿Los dos?
Yes.
¿Pueden los dos, tú y Lisa, llevarme a la estación? ¿O either or neither?
Entiendo. Ah, o sea, es literal el ambos. Yo lo conocía como el ambos.
Sí, ambos, sí. Sí. Uh-huh. Ambos también, sí.
Listo.
Bueno, entonces la tres. Are you from Spain or from Italy? Which one do you think it is?
Neither, no.
Neither? What about this one?
Both of us.
This one?
Maybe, I don't know.
Okay. Don't worry, because when we apply the answers, they're gonna give you the correct one, and they're gonna tell you why is the wrong or the right one. With a tourist visa, you can neither work nor study. ¿Por qué me hace siempre esto? Hey, este Zoom. Siempre me hace lo mismo. ¿Por qué me hace esto si yo lo abrí? Hey, si yo tengo una cuenta. Tengo la cuenta y siempre me sale esto. Ve, ¿ahora qué hago aquí? Back. Ve. ¿Y ahora qué hago? Ya quedé parqueado, vea. Ya ni para atrás ni para adelante. Zoom. ¿Cuál era? ¿Cuál era el que estábamos viendo? Yo ya no sé ni cuál estábamos viendo, ni dónde estábamos. Aquí no estábamos, ¿cierto? Ah, es aquí. ¿Trin? Ok. Bueno, si se va, les mando el link otra vez. This one right here. With a tourist visa, you can work or not study.
Either.
He showed us two apartments, but we didn't like.
Neither.
John and Sarah were invited.
Neither.
Huh? Neither?
No,
either.
Either,
okay. This one.
Brother, excuse me.
Go ahead.
In the fifth, is neither.
This one?
It's a tourist visa, you can neither work nor study.
Okay, and over here, the tennis game was fantastic. Yo saqué cuatro malas de este primero.
The tennis game was fantastic. Either.
Neither. Yes. Both.
Either. The match was really boring. Team play well.
Neither.
Neither. And this one, you can choose neither, both, neither of those two presents. Which one do you prefer?
Both of those. Both.
Yes, both.
Okay. Check the answers.
Yes.
In 6 minutes that we have. Okay, the first one. The first one is wrong. Correct answer is either. Say, we can say either A or B to mean one person, thing or the other. Aquí era either. Eran dos personas. You and Lisa. Can either you and Lisa take me to the station? This one was either. Very good. Why either? Says, why neither? We say neither of plus you, then to mean zero out of two people. Very good. This one is good too. Not A or not B. That's good. This one is good. This one is good. This one right here, neither. He showed us two apartments, but we didn't like neither of them. The one was either of them. Remember negative? Remember negative verb? We use either.
Mm-hmm.
Remember? We cannot use both or neither with a negative verb. See? Negative verb. We have to use either. Either John or Sarah were invited. Both. We use both. And to mean two people or thing. And. With that, the and aquí means both. Both. It was not or. O sea, que hubiera sido John or Sarah. Either John or Sarah. That's different. It was and. The tennis game was fantastic. Either players were great. No, it says both. We use both plus plural. Plural, players. See? Players. Plural noun. And either, neither, plus singular noun. Over here, if you say player, then we can use either or neither. Because this is a plural noun. So we use both. This one is good. And this one right here. We got 4 more minutes. You can choose both of those two present. Which one do you prefer? Prefer? We can say either A or B to mean one person, thing or other, or the other. So we can use, we use either. You can choose either, both, either this one or that one. Por eso se usa either, porque es o ese de allá o este de acá. No son los dos al mismo tiempo, sino que se escoge uno de esos dos. Por eso se usamos either, no usamos both. ¿Ok? Quedan 4 minutos. Este es más bueno. Este es más fácil, vea. Lo mismo, both, neither. Both, either, or neither. Which one do you pick?
You can...
Neither.
¿Qué dijo Sister Viviana?
Either.
Either? Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Either, this one. I don't know if this one. Okay. This one right here, second one. We got 3 minutes and 45 seconds.
Or work. Neither. Neither. I am in the car.
Are you at home or at work? Okay. Three.
I don't know which one to watch. Both of them.
Both of them, okay. I didn't like.
Didn't like either. Both of them.
Remember the verb? If the verb is in negative, which one we use?
Either.
This last one?
I was. He was. Neither. I don't know. I'm not sure.
Okay, we see. We see. Ay, Estefanio llegó tarde. Ya cuando se va a apagar el coso. Okay. Check answers. Let's see. Check answers. You have completed the test. Okay. The first one. Good. The second one. Good. The third one. Good. Uy. The fourth one, good. The fifth one, good. And the last one. Either. Either was the right question. The right question. We can say either A or B to mean a person, thing, or. Remember this all over here? Remember the all over here? Huh? Cuando hay un train o un bus, usamos either. Pero cuando hay un and, ¿se acuerda de ese and?
Es que esa fue porque no la respondimos, brother.
Sí,
solo respondimos, ¿no? Hasta las 5.
Solo hasta las 5.
Ah, no, con razón. Antes todas están malas.
Ajá, porque solo fue hasta las 5. Sí, porque solo respondimos la página. Bueno, sí, solo hasta las 5, porque esa no la respondimos, esa del bus. No me acuerdo.
Ah, ni, pero esa la vamos a responder ahora que volvamos. Bueno, vamos a mandar el link otra vez.
Con el mismo, otro nuevo.
No, yo creo que con el mismo.
Listo, entonces entramos con eso.
Listo, vamos a salir.